gearing up for the final road game of the season. Welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty in a big Week 13 matchup with the Bowling Green Falcons. Illinois Tech enters ranked 15th in the nation and winners of their last seven, but this streak could be in trouble. Bowling Green not having a very impressive season right now, only 4-5, but they definitely gave this Wolfpack defense some trouble last year. But the good news for the Wolfpack is that Bowling Green's without their starting running back and starting left tackle. And we'll see how that shakes up the Bowling Green offense this week as Gonzalez has the ball teed up and sends this one deep to T.O. Redding. From the 7, Redding working his way upfield across the 25 and tackled by Orton shy of the 30. And out comes the Bowling Green offense led by quarterback James Morgan. They start in the shotgun as Morgan throws on first down and looks left to Tim Tupa across the 40 and a 15-yard pickup out the gate for the Falcons. Shouldn't see too much running from Morgan this week. He does most of his damage from the pocket as they go screen on first down out to Ponsack and brought down near midfield. That's good for 7. Still in the shotgun on second down, Morgan this time going screen left to T.O. Redding, and this time Matt Gorton there behind the line. Good tackle forcing 3rd and 4. Defense stacking the box on third down, expecting run, but Jennings out the backfield as Morgan looks to throw and to the sideline as Jennings can't hold on, and 4th down upcoming, and Bowling Green will punt. Or at least it looks this way to get this play started as Baker's deep on the return. This punt sent downfield by Davidson, and that one going out of bounds inside the 10-yard line, so a great punt from Davidson. And out comes the Illinois Tech offense. Bishop had a great game last week on the ground and also through the air. 1st down, play fake. Bishop picks up a blitz, and that could have been trouble for Kelly as he gets this one out to Jay Miller. And a 6-yard gain for the fullback. 2nd down and 4. Kelly to throw once again. Pressure coming through as he throws underneath to Edwards, and a 6-yard gain for the freshman as they pick up a 1st down. Miller in motion on 1st down. They go to the ground for the first time. This is Bishop trying to work left and brought down after a short gain, only good for 3. Wolfpack still in the pistol on 2nd down as Kelly fakes it, tries to throw the football, and pressure coming off the edge. That pass goes incomplete. 3rd down. Looking to convert on 3rd down and 7. This is Kelly to throw, and across the middle there is McKnight, and he's brought down near the marker in a favorable spot. That's a 7-yard pickup, but I don't think he got it. No challenge from Bowling Green, so the drive will continue. 1st down and 10. There's Jason Howard upfield, and a lot of guys getting the football early as the junior receiver finds 9 yards. 2nd down and 1, going to the ground game. Counter right to Bishop, and he's brought down behind the line. 3rd down again. Trying to avoid plays like that as much as possible. 3rd down and 5, check down Bishop, spinning upfield, then he's brought down shy of the 1st down, and the Wolfpack will punt. So a good first possession for the Illinois Tech offense, but couldn't find a way to keep that drive going. Morgan throwing on 1st down, and Dwyer gives up 12 to T.O. Redding. Got to find a way to keep him contained. He caused a lot of problems for this defense last year. 1st and 10, there's Tim Tupa again, and that's Paul McCray with the tackle after a 6-yard pickup. 3rd down and 4 for Bowling Green as Morgan looks to throw left, and Redding's left wide open, makes the grab despite the contact, and not too sure what happened there. Someone should have been there in coverage. 2nd down, Morgan from the gun and brought down by Land Min as the pressure got through, bringing up 3rd and 18. They're backed up to the 35-yard line. Morgan needing 18 yards, steps up, fires right. This is Root behind the defense, and a 1st down as Mac Orton got caught flat-footed. Just another big play he's given up this year. 1st and goal, this is Morgan to throw in. A check down the Roop over the middle. That is a 5-yard gain to bring up 2nd and goal from the 2. Expecting run here at the goal line, but Morgan throwing end zone and touchdown T.O. Redding. He got away from David Davis. And it's a Bowling Green touchdown to put them on the board first. 7-0 ball game here, still in the first quarter as they go back to Bishop on 1st down, weaving his way through the defense and brought down shy of the marker. That's good for about 9 yards. From the shotgun on 2nd down and 1 as Kelly looks to throw, and pressure gets through from Bowling Green. And Kelly's got to throw that ball away. You can't take a sack right there on 2nd and short. From the 30, 3rd down and 10, 5 wide set for Kelly as he looks to throw outside, and Shelton can't get across the marker. But the offense stays on the field. And as Caden Garrick in his 1st carry of the ball game, as he nearly sneaks through the defense, he could still be running. But a 3-yard gain to take us into the 2nd quarter. Now 2nd and 5 for the offense. Bishop lined up wide as a receiver, makes the grab, spins upfield, makes 2 guys miss, and finds 21 yards. Had a big game last week through the air, expecting more passes thrown his way in this game as well. Getting close to field goal range for Gonzalez as Bishop carries right on first and 10 and finds about 6 yards. Now the offense facing third and one, going stretch left, and Bishop's got nowhere to go as they end up losing 2 yards. So out comes Gonzalez for a 42-yard try from the left hash as the kick is up, and this one is nowhere even close as Gonzalez continues to struggle. This started last week, and whatever's going on is still continuing this week as well. So no points for the Wolfpack here in the first half as they go back to Jennings. And a carry by Jennings finds 7 yards and a first down. He's been running pretty well this ball game. First down and 10. Morgan to throw. Pressure coming through as he flips this one out. 2 pond sack and a catch for a first down. Give him 15 yards and Bowling Green across midfield. From the shotgun again, Morgan looks to throw. And outside to Tupa this time around as they continue to get separation from these safeties. And that's good for 13 yards. Having a hard time keeping all these guys in check. Second down, Morgan again, unpressured. And throwing outside again to Ponsack. That time they went zone, and he still got open. Got to find a way to keep these guys contained. Second down, Jennings with the football as he runs through a defender, falls ahead, and nearly picks up a first down. Should have been a loss of 1 or 2. Instead, he finds 10 yards. Third and inches, they come out in a heavy pistol set going to Jennings, and he's wrapped up behind the line by Reeves and Hunter. But the offense stays on the field for 4th and 1. Toss left, Jennings gets the edge, and he's going to walk in for the touchdown. McCray took a bad angle. And it's a 13-0 lead for the Falcons here in the second quarter. Number 15, Illinois Tech, not off to a great start this week. Still some time left in the first half, 3 minutes roughly to go as Kelly looks to throw on first down out to Shelton. And he's left wide open. That's good for 17 yards. That'll get them down to midfield in a hurry. First and 10. Kelly again to throw. Pressure coming from his right. Throws intercepted by Bozeman. And now is Bowling Green in midfield. Kelly into double coverage. Felt the pressure coming from his right. Instead of trying to run or maybe throwing the ball away, it's only first down. Threw the ball in the double coverage. And of course, he's going to hear about that from head coach Chris Hall. That is not a smart decision. Already down 14 points. And here comes Bowling Green back to Jennings, finding some space in. Jennings with a big-time first-down run, good for 14 yards. Starting to really work him here in the second quarter, already 6 carries. Back in the pistol on second down, back to Jennings up the middle, and Jennings wrapped up after a short gain by Ashley Curtis. Might see more playing time from Curtis this week. 3rd down and 8, Morgan trying to go screen right to Domer, and this is well-read by Hunter, and a 4th down coming up for Bowling Green, but on the edge of field goal range. And they're going to go for it. This will be a near 50-yard field goal from the right hash as the kick is up. And this is drilled. That could have been a 55, maybe a 60-yard kick. And it's 17-0 Bowling Green. This offense has got to get something going with one timeout and 1:29 left on the board. But here goes Baker from 5 yards deep. Working upfield. Finds a lane across the 40 across midfield. And Baker is gone. And there goes the big play this team needed. Baker always coming through in the clutch. And a new NCAA record. But more importantly, Illinois Tech is finally on the board with a score of their own. As Baker goes 105 yards, beating McKnight's return of 104 that he set when Baker was injured earlier this year. So back and forth with his record. And we'll see if maybe he can bring another one back in this ball game, because they will definitely need some points as Gonzalez cannot hit anything. But still a 2-score ball game with a lot of time left in the first half for Bowling Green with 3 timeouts, and this defense cannot allow another score. Time to step up and get these guys off the field. 2nd down for Morgan. Throwing to Redding, and Redding can't hold on. Passes dropped incomplete. 3rd down. So a great chance here to get off the field, get the ball back to the offense as Morgan looks to throw again. And across the middle for Ponsack, who's wide open. And into Illinois Tech territory. They're already in field goal range with 3 timeouts still to use. Clock dribbling down inside of a minute. This is Morgan under pressure and brought down again. That is Kendrick Royal. And that brings up 2nd and long. Now 3rd and 15. Cannot allow a first down here as Morgan steps right and is brought down again as Landman for the 2nd time. And a big play there from the senior forces 4th and 23. And Bowling Green, a 57-yard try from the right hash. It has a leg, but it's just a little off to the right, so the defense clearly just got him outside of field goal range. That was pretty impressive. But 41 seconds left in the half, 17-6 ball game. No timeouts left for the offense. Can they get down the field and make something happen here as Kelly throws to the freshman? There's Eric Torrios for a 1st down to stop the clock. up to midfield, second down. This is Trios once again working towards the marker, gets the first down, stops the clock again. 23 seconds left, getting close to field goal range, but do you trust your kicker at this point as Kelly throws incomplete and trying to check that one down to Trios. 19 seconds left, Bishop out the backfield. They go five wide from the pistol as Kelly looks to throw down the seam for Bishop, and he's got the grab. He laid out for it. They have first and goal at the two-yard line. What a catch from Bishop. Clock stopped at 15 seconds, but what a grab from Bishop. That is absolutely a perfect throw from Kelly and a perfect grab from Bishop. Inside of 10 seconds, last play of the first half, and is Bishop on the toss outside for a Wolfpack touchdown. It's 17-12 with 4 seconds left, and they found a way to claw their way back to this ball game, and they're going to go for two to make it a field goal ball game. Shotgun set for Kelly. They go four wide, and of course, up the middle, there is Bishop, and he's in for the score. And we have a field goal ball game heading into the second half as we have a potential upset here in the SEC. LSU trailing Auburn by 7. But still 1 second left in the first half, and Bowling Green will take their shot downfield as they line up for a Hail Mary. This is Morgan having time to throw, looks downfield. This is caught by Ponsack, but no time remaining. What a throw from Morgan, but 14-7, Illinois Tech trails at halftime by 3. And they'll look to avoid a Week 13 upset as the second half's coming up next. Well, this has been an interesting first half. Illinois Tech trailed by 17, found a way to claw their way back into this ball game, but a lot of time left, and we could see a lot more scoring by the time this ball game is done. Illinois Tech does have the ball first to begin the second half, so we'll see if they can find a way to at least tie the ball game up or maybe even take the lead to begin the third quarter. But with the way the kicking has been going so far, Gonzalez, no extra points, no field goals. This could be a very interesting second half of play, as so far things have been very even, Steven, but only 16 yards rushing so far for Bishop and Garrett combined. That is a bit of an oddity for this offense. Baker from 4 yards deep, bringing this one out, and he's wrapped up across the 25-yard line, a 31-yard return. As Illinois Tech gets started from the 26-yard line, going with the ground game to Bishop as he breaks a tackle and finds 8 yards. So obviously the run game, a point of emphasis for the offense in the second half as they go back to Bishop this time, right side, and he's wrapped up near the 40, and that carried good for 7 yards. So 2 runs. Already 15 yards, so the run game obviously is working well, but they go play fake on first down. Kelly's got a little room to work with as he gets to the 40 and decides to throw the football, and is intercepted by Milton. And he's going to return this one into Illinois Tech territory as Kelly throws his second bad pick of the ball game. Both picks into traffic. I don't know what Kelly was looking at there. Maybe he thought that corner would maybe slide with Shelton across the field, but he stayed with Archer. And that is not the start this offense needed in the third quarter. First 2 runs worked well, but the first throw gets picked off as Morgan throws in a wide open receiver, and he's down inside the 10-yard line, a 29-yard pickup. What is going on with this team this week? First and goal, back to Jennings, and he is wrapped up behind the line. Nice tackle there from Hunter as he loses 2 yards. Second and goal from the 11-yard line. They go sweep left to Jennings. Hunter trying to make the play, but Hunter misses. And Jennings in for a second touchdown. And it's a 23-14 lead, so Illinois Tech down by 2 scores again as Hunter just whiffed. And that was just a pretty bad user on my end. 10-point ball game, Illinois Tech going from the pistol to an option. And a 3-yard gain for Kelly, already bringing up 3rd down and 8. Got to find a way to convert here. Kelly from the pistol once again looks to throw down the seam. There's Archer in space and across midfield. That's good for 20. Second down, Illinois Tech goes 5 wide. Kelly from the shotgun, and they go screen underneath to McKnight, and he can't get separation. Only a 1-yard gain, 3rd down once again. Already halfway through the third quarter, 4 minutes to go, 3rd down and 5. They'll trust Kelly to pick this one up through the air, and tight coverage on the outside as Kelly tried to force that to McKnight, and luckily not picked off for the third time. But the offense staying on the field, 4th down and 5, 5 wide set as Kelly looks left again. This time it's the freshman, and with contact that time, he finds 13 yards. Torrios with 2 big grabs to end the first half, got to find a way to get him more involved in this half as well. 2nd down, up the middle goes Bishop, blocked from Edwards, and he's brought down inside the 5-yard line at the 2. 21-yard pickup, good blocking the field by the tight end. First and goal, Garrick in the ball game. Kelly keeps the football, made the wrong read, loses 3 yards. Now second and goal from the 5. Still in the pistol, second and goal, back to the option, and Kelly at the goal line is met, and they say he broke the plane. Touchdown, Illinois Tech. In a 4-point ball game, the extra point would make it a field goal game, but the offense staying on the field once again, and they will go for 2. Jumbo set running left, and Garrick finds the end zone. Great block in the field by the O-line against that blitz. And his studio update time once again is number 1 UCLA in a tight one with unranked USC. So it's Bowling Green from near midfield. Morgan play fake, throws to Tim Tupa. First down, good for 13 yards. Their drive starting off pretty well. In the Illinois Tech territory already, Morgan under pressure from McCray, throws outside, and that should have been intentional grounding, but no call from the officials. 4-wide shotgun set again for Morgan on second down as he looks to throw. Receivers breaking open downfield, but a check down, and he's picked off by Paul McCray. Already breaking away downfield, Jennings giving chase inside the 20. McCray losing steam, but finds a way to get in the end zone for his second pick six of the season. And there's the first lead for the Wolfpack today on James Morgan's first mistake. What an addition Paul McCray has been for this team. The JUCO linebacker has easily been one of the big standout players for this defense this year. I don't know where this defense would be without him. One of the best tacklers on the team, one of the best linebackers on the team. And Gonzalez is out of his slump, finally. 5-point ball game here in the third quarter. All it took was a pick six. Can they do it again? First and 10, back to Jennings, and he is wrapped up near the line of scrimmage. Only a short gain, good for 3. Still haven't seen a ton of running from Jennings this ball game, mostly throwing from Morgan as Morgan looks to the outside. There's Jennings uncovered as he finds a first down. Someone was not where they were supposed to be on that play. Second and 7. Morgan from the shotgun. They go back to Jennings up the middle, and he's wrapped up after a short gain, good for 4, as that brings up 3rd and 3. Morgan to throw once again outside to Tupa, and Tupa near the marker but can't get the first down. But their offense not going anywhere. 4th and inches. Heavy pistol set back to Jennings, and McCray there from behind, but not before Jennings got the first down. He picked up 2 yards. 2nd down and 10, going back to a screen right to Jennings, and a stop by McCray, and then eventually Spencer Simmons as they lose 3 yards before his 3rd and 13. Could be the last play of the third quarter. 13 seconds left, going screen left to Jennings once again, and Jennings able to get some room but can't get enough for the first down as McCray's there again. And no super long field goal from Bowling Green this time. They will punt the ball back to Illinois Tech. Trying to set up a screen left to Bishop on first down, but not much room to run. Good coverage downfield by Bowling Green. And a play later, now looking at 3rd down and 5. Bishop from the pistol carries upfield, then is spun down shy of the marker. And they will give it back to Bowling Green. So it looks like they're trusting their defense to maintain this lead as Morgan throws downfield on first down. And that's either miscommunication or Morgan just got away with another intentional grounding call. Regardless, 2nd and 10 for Bowling Green as Morgan to throw once again outside to Ponsack as Hunter gets beaten. Morgan with another big throw, nearing 300 yards passing. To the 40-yard line, Morgan to throw once again outside to Tupa, and Tupa gets away from Hunter as he picks up 19 yards. Hunter definitely a liability in man coverage. Jennings in motion on 1st and 10 as Morgan throws underneath to Tupa, and a 5-yard gain to bring up 2nd and 5. They're inside the 20. And obviously not looking for a field goal. 3rd down and 7 now for Bowling Green from the 20-yard line as Morgan has a 5-wide set on the field as he throws for the end zone. And there goes Tim Tupa for a touchdown. And a 1-point lead now for Bowling Green with 5:07 to go in the 4th quarter. So obviously they will go for 2 and make it a field goal ball game. Going to Jennings, and he's ripped down behind the line by Hunter coming off the edge. And a studio update once again as LSU and Auburn still in a close battle. Auburn still up by 3 points, but LSU is closing the gap. We would obviously love to see number 1 and number 2 go down this week, but number 15's got to worry about picking up this win because they are not doing a great job defensively as they go back to Bishop on first down, and he finds about 10 yards as he nears 100 on the ball game. 17 carries, 88 yards. Not seeing the same balance between Bishop and Garrick that we saw last week, but a carry left for Bishop. Big blocks downfield from the tight ends and the receivers as Bishop's inside the Bowling Green 30. Who needs an offensive line when you've got a guy like McKnight taking out the corner, then taking out the safety, just clearing that lane for Bishop. Big time run there, big time blocking. And Illinois Tech back in the field goal range once again. First and 10. Play fake out to Archer and a near first down. That catch good for 9. Bowling Green looked like they were bringing heat. They did. Second and inches. Same look from the defense as Kelly gives it to Bishop out the backfield. And Bishop's got the first down and more. He's got a touchdown. His second of the ball game and a 5-point lead with 3:24 to go. Illinois Tech might want to think about slowing the pace down in this ball game, but a 2-point conversion to make it a touchdown game, and Bishop can't get around the edge. As the defense brought heat, that time they got the stop. And this game now in the hands of the Illinois Tech defense, 3:19 to go. Morgan under pressure from Corbin throws this one out of bounds. How is that not intentional grounding? Morgan not getting calls this game. Second down and 10, again throwing this time over the middle to Domer as he gets away from one and is brought down near the 45. That's good for 17 yards. Got to find a way to keep those receivers contained, even the running backs. They go to the ground on first and 10 with Jennings, and he gets the first down, breaks away from Reeves, and is brought down inside the Illinois Tech 35. Looking for a stop on third down, going to Jennings from the shotgun up the middle. Jennings inside the 15, down to the 10. That's good for 16 yards. And is Bowling Green pacing well, with pacing maybe a little too quickly? So a lot of time left as Morgan throws end zone and touchdown Darian Landry as Hunter gets beat again in man coverage. So is Bowling Green up by 1 point again, and they'll need a 2-point conversion to make it a field goal ball game with 2:29 to go in the fourth quarter. So again, lining up in that shotgun split back set as Morgan looks to throw again over the middle, and is knocked away by Deion Reeves. What a play in man coverage. He almost gave up that touchdown, but a great play in the end zone keeps it at a 1-point ball game as Illinois Tech looks to take the lead with 2:25 to go. They start with the run, and Bishop finds 5 yards on his first carry of this possession. Do you trust Kelly to keep throwing here in the clutch? Second down, Kelly underneath to Shelton. And Shelton upfield past the marker, good for 8 yards. So far, so good for Illinois Tech on this possession. First and 10 from the 35-yard line, going counter right. And Bishop is met in the backfield as they lose 3. And there goes their first timeout. Now it's second and 18 after a false start. 5-wide set for Kelly as he looks to throw in a check down to the freshman. There's Torrios upfield and an 8-yard gain to bring up third and 11. Obviously, 4-down territory, but you would like to avoid a 4th down in this situation. Illinois Tech to the air on 3rd down, and McKnight finds a 1st down, good for 17, as Bowling Green brought heat. 1:13 left for the Wolfpack as Kelly looks towards the sideline again. There's McKnight with a 15-yard grab, 1st down, and getting close to field goal range. But obviously, they don't trust their kicking at this point. Gonzalez still being inconsistent as Bishop finds 12. 14 seconds left, still with 2 timeouts. Bishop working left and is brought down inside the 5-yard line and near the 1st down marker. There goes their 2nd timeout. 3rd and inches. 8 seconds left, goal line package give to the fullback, and Miller finds a 1st down, stops the clock at 6 seconds. And they'll save that timeout. 1st and goal, 4 seconds left. Toss right for Bishop, and he's in for the touchdown. His 3rd of the ball came, and the Wolfpack take the lead with 1 second left. And they didn't get the extra points, so a 5-point ball game as Gonzalez with a squib down the field. Then this is just going to be fallen on by Murphy, so no time running off the clock. And it's Hail Mary time once again for Bowling Green. No time remaining. Morgan steps up, hit by Corbin, passes in the air, man. This time Bowling Green can't catch it. And there goes the ball game as Illinois Tech picks up their 8th win in a row. This one a lot closer than in previous weeks. Just finding a way to squeak out a win this week as Bishop had a great 2nd half. Remember, 16 yards combined between him and Garrick in the 1st half. He ended with a huge game of 172 yards rushing, plus his impact through the air. 3 touchdowns. I mean, you can't complain with that performance. I think we came into this game expecting a shootout. We got the shootout that we were looking for, but this game would have been a lot easier if Gonzalez was making field goals and making extra points. Unfortunately, kicking still an issue, but kick returning is not an issue. Lucas Baker, 6 returns, 255. Great game from him. And obviously, we saw the defense a little exposed this week as Morgan threw 3 touchdowns, almost 400 yards passing, and almost gave up 100 yards rushing. So obviously, more of a challenge this week than we've seen the past couple of weeks against Western Michigan, Air Force, and Toledo. Although Toledo gave us a pretty good game, but Bowling Green definitely gave us the best game we've had since, I believe, week 8 against Eastern Michigan. But this game really just came down to who had the ball last, And we will head into the last game of the regular season. Week 14, taking on Ball State, and no commitments this week, but Jason Hicks, the left end, finally ready to visit. And of course, you see, we are in battles for so many people, but Coach of the Year finalist. Obviously, we just won our eighth straight game. Finalist for the Thorpe Award, finalist for best returner, finalist for best linebacker, and finalist for the Bednarik Award. So we have a lot of guys who might be bringing home awards this year, as we only got one last year from Lucas Baker. But the Bednarik Award is led by Paul McCray, beating out guys from Georgia, BYU, Bama, UCLA. Also the best linebacker award, McCray at number five, is somehow he's leading for the Bednarik, but not best linebacker. Thorpe Award, Hunter down at number nine, so he's still in the running, although I don't think he's going to win it unless he has like a huge game with nine interception returns. But Baker at number nine for best returner, how is he at number nine? That is highway robbery. But moving into recruiting, David James, we are climbing his board. So obviously, most of the guys on our board right now will be guys that we don't actually get commitments from. We'll have to wait till signing day later on. So it's going to be a little tight towards the end, and we're going to have to kind of balance who we want, who we don't want. But Jason Hicks is the guy I definitely want on our team next year, even if he redshirts behind Corbin. And he will be ready to come in week 14 for a visit with Illinois Tech as we take on Ball State in the final game of the year. And this will be our senior week as Ball State enters 5-6, 2-5 in the conference. Very middle of the mall team, but obviously a win for them gets them into a bowl game. So we are expecting a challenge from Ball State in this final game of the year. And of course, they would love to spoil our senior day. But that, guys, is it for today's episode of the Illinois Tech Dynasty. We are moving pretty steadily into maybe the top 10 if we can find a win. Probably not the top 10, but if we win this game, win the MAC championship, then win a bowl game, we could finish in the top 10. Maybe. That's a big maybe. But I'm excited to see where this season ends. And obviously ready to get into season number 3. But thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed the episode. A tight one here in week 13. But the Wolfpack getting the job done thanks to a big time play by Paul McCray. And let's go get this guy a Bednarik Award. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.